Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. NASA astronaut Kjell Lindgren made several appearances in the D.C. area April 25th through 29th to share highlights of his recent five-month mission aboard the International Space Station. On Tuesday morning at the Smithsonian National Air and Space Museum, he showed imagery from his spaceflight and answered questions. That evening, Lindgren threw out the first pitch at Nationals Park before the Major League Baseball game between Washington and Philadelphia. He also attended the Tech Day on Capitol Hill event on Thursday that highlighted technology development and research being conducted on the station to help NASA achieve its future missions. Deputy Administrator David Newman was one of the NASA officials to participate in the Smithsonian Magazine's The Future is Here Festival on April 24th at the Shakespeare Theater Company's Sidney Harmon Hall in Washington. Jim Green, NASA's Director of Planetary Science, also participated. The annual festival began in 2013 to bring together experts in science, technology, space exploration, and arts to explore new horizons of human knowledge and eye-opening possibilities for the future. NASA Commercial Crew astronauts Eric Bo and Sonny Williams tested new training simulators at Boeing's St. Louis headquarters on April 26th. The new part task trainers will help the astronauts become familiar with normal operations of the company's CST-100 Starliner spacecraft and safely train for unexpected issues crews might encounter on flights to the International Space Station. Last year, NASA selected Bo, Williams, Bob Behnken, and Doug Hurley to train for upcoming commercial crew test flights aboard the Starliner and SpaceX's Crew Dragon spacecraft. Aircraft crews and mechanics at NASA's Armstrong Flight Research Center have been busy preparing a DC-8 and King Air aircraft to conduct science flights May 2nd to June 14th in South Korea as part of the Korean U.S. Air Quality Mission, or CHORUS AQ. The joint campaign between NASA and South Korea's National Institute of Environmental Research is one of eight Earth Expedition's field studies NASA is conducting this year. The mission will combine observations from aircraft, satellites, ships, and ground stations to assess air quality across urban, rural, and coastal areas of South Korea. The data collected will be used to help find new solutions to the air pollution health threat, not just on the Korean Peninsula, but all around the world. Scientists at NASA's Marshall Space Flight Center in Huntsville, Alabama, have partnered with the National Center for Atmospheric Research in Boulder, Colorado, and other institutions to produce a map that can help forecast the potential spread of Zika virus in the United States. The research team looked at several key factors, including temperature, rainfall, and socioeconomic factors that contribute to the spread of the virus, to understand where and when a potential outbreak may occur. The fifth annual International Space Apps Challenge, April 22nd through 24th, featured astronaut Doug Wheelock at the Global Main Stage event in Pasadena, California, which included a data boot camp and a 48-hour hackathon. In all, activities for this year's challenge, sponsored by NASA's Office of the Chief Information Officer, took place in more than 161 locations in 73 countries, with participants using NASA data to develop software, hardware, mobile apps, and other possible solutions for space exploration missions and issues on Earth. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on social media and visit www.nasa.gov/twan.